Season is back, and so are we. Art Hunsinger along, former PBA turned pro, Kenny Hall, and we are here at Highway Recreational for our last scratch show of the season before our big year-end tournament. And Kenny, what a tournament it's going to be today with the number of people we've had have been on the show before and have done very well.
Tricky little pattern Artie's laid out there. You got to be careful. Some players are going to play out from the right. Some players are going to play in the middle. And it's going to go through a transition, so we'll see how the players adapt.
That Artie Hoffmann is pretty tricky, huh?
Yes, he is. I don't know
how it goes today. We'll be back here at Highway Recreation in Wynantskill, New York, for Huckman's Capital Region Bowl, and here on My Four Albany.
Welcome back. Huckman's Capital Region Bowl, here on My Four Albany. Coming to you from Highway Recreation in Wynantskill. And Kenny, that is little Peyton.
She Happy is birthday.
Five. Yes, yeah, indeed. 5 years old today. And she's here bowling. Who knows? She might be on our show someday.
What a great way to start off our show with a five-year-old. That's the future of our bowling show. So let's
Absolutely.
Go for it.
Beautiful. All right. Well, our next to last show of the 13th season today, and we've got some veterans. So let's get started. Nick Miseno from Ballston Lake, averaging 230 a game, 369s, and 817 800s, excuse me, and he bowls out of Town Bowling Academy. He's going up against Scott Earl from Tom Earl from Schenectady. Oh God, you're averaging 239 with 23 300s and 12 800s. He also bowls from Town Bowling Academy. So the battle of the Town Bowling Academy bowlers here today at Highway Recreational in Wynantskill. And Kenny, we've seen both of these guys before, especially Nick just recently this year.
Yeah, Tommy doesn't bowl a lot of tournaments, but when he does, he's always competitive. Both players, really good friends of mine, and I can't pick a favorite here.
Nick had a choice, and he chose to have Tom start on lane five.
Ball coming back, going to get it. Oh, almost got the sweeper. Bowling on a pattern here called the Broadway pattern. In the beginning, it's going to play from the right. It's a shorter pattern. And as the games go by, it's probably going to migrate to the left. So we'll see who can make the fastest moves. Now, Renee, Tommy's wife, said if he leaves a 10-pin in the first frame and he misses it, she's going to leave, because the last three times they've been on the show. Where is she?
Oh, I guess she's not leaving. She seems to be very happy right now, too.
That was awesome. And she really told me that.
Well, I guess she's going to stay now at least
exactly.
For the rest of this match. So, all right. Nick Miseno up on lane number six.
Nick, he's a very good playing from the right. Straight arm swing. Going to set. Got that left to target.
Ooh, a lot of head pin there.
Yeah, lucky just to leave, too.
Very lucky.
Just a 3-6.
Nick married to Isabella for 7 years, and they have a 7-year-old son on March 30th, Nicholas.
Great spare.
Good pickup for Nick. Nick not wearing one of our typical Huck Finn shirts because he is sponsored on his bowling by Hammer, which is the product he is using today.
Nicky was just motioning with his shoulder. If his shoulder gets too far open, the ball goes to the right of his hip, and that makes it go left. So he's going to try and square up, keep those shoulders and hips nice and square. Much better shot there. There you go, buddy.
Thanks, 10. He's one of those bowlers that has that little routine each time before he starts.
Yeah, he does a lot of visualization. He pictures things in his mind before it happens. I was a big believer in that when I was bowling.
Tom up on lane six for his second ball. Tom's an auditor with the New York State Department of Motor Vehicle.
Tommy, 5 steps. Great shot right there. Really good ball speed. Sort of like shovels the ball down the lane. It means it's not going to hook early, which means it's going to stay in play, which means you're going to get some spares to shoot at. So he's not going to beat himself.
After two, we are all tied up. A spare and a strike for each.
Yeah. five short steps. Clean off his hand again. Yes, sir.
And then another one.
Putting some pressure on Tommy early.
Yeah, and as we've talked about before, there's not a lot of room to hide in a one-match contest.
Exactly. And the thing is, the harder you work mentally and the harder you practice, the easier it is when you get under the pressure and under the gun. Going left.
He gets six on
Tommy's
an open.
He's having some footing issues right now, but I think it's because his shoulders are so far forward that he's putting a lot of friction on that foot. And when you try, if you go far with your spine angle and you shove that slide, and then you're trying to get a leverage point, the foot actually slips out from underneath you. And I think that's what Tommy's doing.
So he's trying to throw it hard. Balance, yeah, so he's not hitting his mark.
He's trying to throw it hard. Another tough spare. Great job.
Johnny picks it up. Nice.
Really good.
Nice pick up. But Nick is ahead by 22 pins at this point through four. So hopefully Tom can adjust for his couple of less frames. And
The game's half over. And you got to figure something out really quick and execute. This tricky little pattern here, you better make good shots. If you don't, it's going to show up immediately. Attaboy.
There he goes. Ten and a fifth for him. Bowlers in the tournament for this week. Narrowed down to the four we will see today. Two of them right now, Nick Miseno and Tom Earl.
Good turnout for our scratch singles tournament. Got it right. Is it going to recover? It did.
Ooh. Almost got lucky there with the pin coming up out of there.
Yep. One pin spare. He missed right. It still recovered. I think he's got a little bit of room out there.
Now, Renee's not going to leave if Tom,
No.
Nick.
Renee, she'll stay. Actually, she might even cheer if Nikki misses this.
She might get excited.
Yeah, it's not going to happen.
Not going to happen. There he goes. Nick picks up the 10 pin here in the fifth frame.
I mentioned the transition. What's going to happen is the player's throwing the ball down the lane. The oil is going to go from the front part of the lane, which is called the heads, to the back part of the lane. And that's going to make them adjust. Later on in the telecast, if Nicky got that ball out there, it might not have recovered.
Nicky credits his dad, grandfather, Carl Wolf.
Shot. Good shot, but
very nice. Harry Palmieri and you.
Harry Palmieri, yep.
As his mentors.
Yeah, I worked with Nicky quite a bit
during his career, and they've all taught him something and coached him along the way.
Good look at Tommy here. Good setup, all about shoulders. Shoulders go forward, shoulders down the lane. What do you got, Mike? Shoved it through his break point.
Yeah, just having a tough time getting into that pocket.
Yeah. Leaving the bucket, 2, 4, 5, 8. Tricky spare, especially when you're bowling on a tricky condition.
And again, not as easy as you think. We've talked about this before. They're all clumped together, but the spacing plays an issue.
There's a foot in between every pin down there. Makes it easy to chop things off. It looks really close up here, like Artie was saying. But very
and
good. Nice
go.
Done.
Nick well focused.
Great shot there.
Back with a strike. So he opened up the door a little bit for Tom. He still has a 20-pin lead at this point through seven. What Tom does now with this little bit of a
big double. Yep, big double right here for Tommy.
Oh.
slapping out that 10. You open the door. Open the door, and here he comes. Cuts that lead in half.
So through eight, Nick still holds a 20-pin lead over Tom. But there is not many frames left.
We got some open play to the left of us, so Tommy's waiting for a young man to do his thing, and we'll get going again.
Full house here today at Highway Rec as we tape our show.
Big shot. This will put us back to even again. Got to get up. Got there.
He got it.
Yes, indeed.
He got a triple, or better known as a turkey.
Yeah. Actually takes the lead by one pin right now. Nicky working on a strike, though. Got it right. Didn't come back. Yes, indeed.
He
answers the call right there.
He's back with a double.
Back to a nine-pin lead.
Nine-pin lead here.
Got it.
In the ninth. Going into the tenth.
Seems to be a little more tug on lane five, a little more push in the middle of the lane. Or lane six has a little more recovery. Nicky set up a little more inside than usual. He's been working on trying to open up that shoulder to create a little more leverage at the bottom of the swing.
There's one.
This one was shut out, Tommy. One more hit.
And another turkey.
Nicky goes out for 237. The best time he can do is 228. A little extra time. Good idea right here. Big shot.
Important ball here.
Got it right. Oh, uh-oh. My goodness. Wow. Solid eight.
Yeah.
Great shot. The bowling gods can be very cruel right now. The best Nicky's got is 226. Tommy can strike out for 228. Wow, what a great shot. Get the spare. Keep your composure.
Yep.
Count's important.
And
good
he
game.
Got it.
Good game, Nick. Wow, what a great shot.
So pretty much Tom needs a strike to start off the 10th. On lane number six here.
Well, when you're a player, all you can ask for is a chance, and this is a chance. Oh, it's got a set. Oh, you're kidding me. Solid
not
nine.
Enough to knock it
oh,
down.
Oh, my goodness. This is a cruel game. Tough pattern, and you make really good shots, but you don't get rewarded. Game time. Nicky Miseno moves on.
All right. And with that, we will be back with semi-match number two here at Hunsinger Capital Region Bowling on My 4 Albany. Welcome back, Hunsinger Capital Region Bowling here at Highway Rec in Wynantskill. And that is the family of one of our bowlers we're going to get to meet here in just a minute, Joe Mazuryk. But first, let's recap our first match. Nick Miseno, 226 over Tom Earl, 206. Nick will move on to the championship match, and he will meet one of the two of these following individuals. Already mentioned Joe Mazuryk. Joe out of DeLanson. with his own cheering squad here today. He has no average because he doesn't bowl in the league. He has 76 career 300s, 25 career 800s, and presently is not bowling in any center. He is going up against a gentleman who bowled in this tournament last year and lost to Mark James, and that is Stephen Caverly. Stephen is from West Sand Lake. He is averaged 213. He has 5 career 300s, 2 career 800s, and he is the hometown boy, Kenny, here from Highway Recreational. So Stephen and Joe in semi-match number 2 of our final single scratch tournament of the year. Now, theoretically, Stephen should have an advantage over everybody because he's used to bowling here under these patterns, but not necessarily true, correct?
Yeah, I don't think he bowls on this pattern in his league. This is a special tournament pattern that Artie came up with. But it's just the surrounding scenes, he's going to be comfortable here. Perfect opening frame right there.
I guess he's very comfortable.
Yes, indeed. Can't throw it any better than that. Both players commenting on how different this pair was from the practice pair. Especially lane 6. Lane 6 seems to be hooking quite a bit more.
Joe, an individual I know you are very familiar with. He states that you've been coaching him since the age of 18.
Good move by Joe. He went left. Also, you notice Joe's so good at changing spine angles, which changes the release point, which changes when the ball breaks on the lane. He's way far forward today because he's got to get the ball down the lane. So it's like pushing a kid on a slide or a swing that's already going downhill.
We have seen Joe on our show over the years, including in our big year-end tournament, the Jack Skatia Memorial.
He's just a tremendous player. He could have turned pro anytime he wanted to and made a good living, but he loves his family and he's home. He's got to hook up. Scout, not going to get it. Two good shots, so hit it. When you hit the pocket, the first two frames, that's a good sign.
His biggest bowling check, he says, is $10,000 in the Bowler's Journal in 1999. So he's bowled some pretty big tournaments
around there. Out in Syracuse, New York, that's a satellite tournament to the USBC National Tournament. I've bowled it, I don't know, 20, 25 years. That's a big win. Everybody bowls that tournament.
One of his big accomplishments, he says, is winning the NEBA 3 times in a row.
That's New England Bowling Association. It's a ton of talent over there. I've been fortunate enough to win one, and it's just a great, great tournament.
Stephen, as I said, we saw last year here when we taped at Highway Rec. He made it to the finals up against Mark James. Mark James, the defending champion of this tournament last year, beat Stephen.
Steve coming in just a little light on lane 6, which appears to be the hooking lane, leaving just the 2-4. 4 steps. No problem.
Nice. Picks it up. And if you really counted it, he's got a 1-pin lead at this point after 2. So we're pretty much even.
Steven, not a tall player, uses up a lot of the approach for pretty big steps. Great shot right there.
He hangs 10 on 5. Seems to like lane 5.
That would be like the Woolworth lane. 5 and 10.
Oh, goodness. I'm not even sure how to answer that.
Joey got that right. He's going to come back. Yes, sir. Ugh. Not quite slapping out the 10 again.
He's got a little bit
of room out there. Yeah, that ball got right again. We saw Nicky miss right on lane 6. He got back also, even the same 10 pin. Changing balls, going cross lane. A lot of ball speed, no hand. There he goes.
3 spares in a row. No turkey call for that, though.
No. might have to think about making some kind of a move. I mean, it's a tricky pattern out there. There's not a lot of room, but if you're consistently hitting the pocket and not carrying, you got to do something.
As I said, in the back behind him, Joe's family, his wife Jamie, sons Chase and Keegan. We have pretty much seen them grow up over the years during our shows.
Yes, indeed.
7 years, and
without a doubt,
Joe's appearances on the TV show, and his mom always here supporting as well.
Joe tried to tighten things up, I think, at lane five, and the ball creeped high, leaving just the 6-10. Good break. We're lucky.
Got it. All right, picked them all up. Needs to turn some of those into strikes. As we get to see Steven coming up on lane six.
Working on a strike. Be a big double. Got it, baby.
Got it.
Yes, indeed.
Doubled up. And at this point has a 12-pin lead through four over Joe.
Joe's probably playing a little mind game with himself right now. What do I do? Do I stay where I am, hit the pocket, take my chances, or do I try and get a little more precise?
And unfortunately, a little move one way or the other can...
Yeah, when they're tricky, there's not a lot of room out there, Artie. You're right. Ball creeping high. Luckily, just a 6-10. Not real good balance right there for Stevie. Stevie not being a tall player. Used on most of the approach with four steps. He's got to really stretch his legs to get that foul line. Very easy to fall off balance. Going with a spare ball. Got it.
And
nice shot.
His first spare on that lane, he was striking. We've talked before about the lights and all, the conditions can change pretty rapidly on these.
Without a doubt. Yep. Especially when you get a short pattern and a very thin velocity or viscosity of oil out there. It doesn't take much to move it around or to actually just literally suck it off the lane.
There he goes.
Good shot, slapping out the 10 right there.
Made a little bit of an adjustment and it worked. First strike of the game in the fifth for Joe.
Big double right here. Chance to answer Steve's double with his a double of his own. You watch Joey's shoulders go a little forward at the foul line. That's how he's throwing it down the lane, changing the spine angle right there. Got it.
And that'll be a double for him. Take us through the sixth and to our commercial break. We'll be right back with more on Huck Finn's Capital Region Bowling on My 4 Albany. All right, we're back. Highway Recreational here in Wynantskill. Huck Finn's Capital Region Bowling. Steve Caverly in the six.
Got to hurry. Got to really hurry.
Ooh.
Strolls got a little too far forward that time. Shoving the ball right through his break point. Into the 1-2-4-6-10. Can be made two ways. You can put the ball in between the head pin and the six pin. Or you can just play like a washout. Just try and wrap the head pin around the 6-10.
Oh.
Good try.
And we've talked about before, it's pretty deceiving because there's more space down there than we see on the camera angle.
Without a doubt, yeah. They look like they're almost touching from back here, and they're not.
All right, he cuts his lead with that open in the sixth.
Big shot, get right back on the horse, Stevie. Better balance. Attaboy.
There he goes. On his favorite lane number five. Joe coming into frame seven with a double. Looking to make it a turkey.
Good job, Joe Church, taking a little extra time so that deep breath relaxes in his body.
And there it is.
Great shot, bud.
You know I'm going to have to gobble at least once before the end of the season, you know.
I saw Johnny the other day. Him and Julia came into the bowling center in Boulder. Got to thank Artie Hoffmann, who's a proprietor here at this place. It's insane the way that he runs things here at Highway Recreation. He just does a great job. Thanks, Art.
Yes, he does. Good turnout here today for our single scratch. Oh, man.
Yeah, Steve, you got a little slow on that one. I liked it off his hand. It was just a little slow. Ball hooking early. 4-6-10.
Back-to-back splits. And he picks up one.
Well, any kind of mark
pretty
here.
Pretty much anything for Joe, and this is over.
Yep.
And that is it. Our winner, Joe Mazuryk, and he will move on to meet Nick Miseno in our championship match, which is coming up next here on Huck Finn's Capital Region Bowling on My4Albany. Welcome back to Highway Recreational and Huck Finn's Capital Region Bowling. Here with our championship match coming up. But first, I want to thank our sponsors who have been with us all season. NYSCOPA, the New York State Correctional Officers Police Benevolent Association, Strike and Spare Pro Shop, Paul Dumas, our friends at Martin Hardy Mazzotti for taking care of our closed captioning this year, and Brunswick Balls for all joining us this year and sponsoring this 13th season. Match number two went like this. Joe Mazuryk, 212, over Steve Caverly, 156. And that brings us here to our final match, the championship match between Joe Mazuryk and Nick Miseno. Our last scratched show of the season. Next week, our season ending Jack Skasia Memorial over at Alpha, and we'll talk about that a little bit here during this match. But right now, we're starting out with Joe Mazuryk on lane number five in the championship match. Whoa. And he leaves the seven. Next week, we move to Alpha Lanes in Troy, Joey Skasia's house, for our Jack Skasia Senior Memorial Tournament, honoring one of the greats from this area, great ambassador of bowling for years. And I know you do him well, Kenny, Jack.
One of my mentors, and he helped me out in so many ways other than just bowling, just in being a decent person, which it's stretching, but I do consider myself a decent person.
Jack, Joey, Michael.
Great opening shot for Nicky.
Good start for him. Spare for Joe.
Joey made a ball change. He used this ball. We were off camera, but he used it for his fill ball, and it went dead flush on lane five, making a good shot there, leaving a seven pin. So, although he's not bowling a lot, the one thing you can't take away from a seasoned player is his brain. He's still thinking and working really hard upstairs. So, on a tricky little pattern, that's a big plus. But he's bowling against Nicky, who's equally intelligent when it comes to lanes and things. Got that right coming back. Oh, yeah. Great shot. Yeah, great shots.
Talking to Nick in between matches, and used to be with Track. He's now with Hammer for the last 2 years. Different product for him, but seems to be working out well.
Actually, he was with Motive. I misspoke. Motive. He's with Motive. Yeah. And what Hammer does different than Motive is it goes a little longer, stores up the energy a little longer for Nick, which is a good thing.
All right, Joe answers with a strike.
That's what this new ball that Joey's throwing out. It reads the back ends a little harder, more continuous. Double-edged sword there. It can be good because it's going to help slap out the corner pins, but if you miss, it's going to go through the nose hard, and bad things are going to happen. So, veteran move. You can't be afraid to make these kind of moves in a one-game match. You just got to go for it and make good shots.
And for your average bowler, you know, different balls don't always play into it because they don't change what they're doing based on lane conditions like the scratch bowler does.
Yes, so many times I'll see a league player or someone who's just in the middle of the road that they make a ball change just because the wind blew. It's like, you know, why are you doing this? You got to have a game plan. There has to be something different to happen. Well, the other ball wasn't working. Make better shots. That was just what I was talking about right there. That ball over red on lane five. Lucky to leave the four pin, kicking out the nine. It's so tricky to match up rotation, number of revolutions with your ball speed. And that's what today's game's all about. You got to match up. You got too much hand and too little ball speed, you're dead. And if you got too much ball and no hand, you're dead. So it's, you got to match up. It's going left. Got away with it.
Ooh.
Got away with it big time.
Oh, man.
Oh, wow. Nice break.
And he knows he got a nice break.
Yeah, just a 70. Talking to Nicky about him setting up inside. He's trying to open up his shoulder a little more on the backswing to create a little more hit at the bottom of his swing. But if that shoulder doesn't get back to square, the ball's going to go left of target. And when you're trying to go straight down the lane, it's kind of tricky. If he was playing left, trying to swing it to the right, it wouldn't be a problem.
And he picks up the seven. So two strikes and a spare starts off this match for Nick.
Yeah, I'll show you what I'm talking about when he sets up. He's setting up a little inside, which means the ball is somewhere around his right thigh. And when he brings it back, he wants to open up that right shoulder so we can snap it at the bottom. If you don't get back to square, it's going to go left on you. Get that in a little, get away with it. That's that transition we were talking about earlier. There's a little more push in the middle of the lane right now, being game three. The first game, that ball probably went through the nose because of the fresh back ends.
And that's part of the trick, is adjusting to those lane conditions because they are going to change.
Exactly. And that, and these two experienced players. There, he got that ball in. And that's where that over-aggressive product, you got to make sure to get that right. Leaving just a 6-10. Good break here.
And he recognized that was lucky.
Yeah.
That 7-pin almost didn't drop. But again, as you say, both of these guys pretty experienced, not just on the local, but
no,
the regional and national tournaments that they have bowled in. So.
Nicky almost won a hoinky for 60,000 one year. And Joey said when the bowler's general. And Nicky's got four regional titles. Joey's got those back-to-back-to-back NBA or NEBA titles.
So they're used to dealing with,
they know what's going on.
Conditions changing. Yeah. I mean,
they're just bowling against the pins, not really bowling against each other right now. Better shot off his hand there. Good shot, Joe.
Nice pickup. So through the fourth, Nick has a 11-pin lead. As he gets up for his fifth. Joey strikes in the fifth.
Good look at Nick right here. Started the ball being a little four. See how it's inside right there. He's going to open up his right shoulder and try to close it at the foul line. That's clean off his hand. That's the best shot of the match for Nick right there.
Double for him in the fifth as he crosses over to the sixth.
And it's kind of ironic, but this is Nicky's A game. Nicky loves to go straight down the boards, where this is not Joe's A game. This is like his B game. He likes to go left to circle it and get it back. So it just gives credit to how good Joey is, even when it's not his condition to play on.
Nick on lane five here in the sixth.
Got it right. Great shot.
And he gets a turkey. And with that, we're going to take a break. And we'll be back for the finals of our championship match here from Highway Recreational. on Huck Finn's Capital Region Bowling on My Floor Albany. Joe Mazuryk in the sixth frame of the championship match here.
Gotta hurry. Got it.
Yeah.
Big double.
Big double for him. Through six. Nick still has a commanding lead, 21 pins. That's not a lot, though.
Well, Joe's working on a double. Exactly. He's working on a double in there. Crunch time. Time to get aggressive. Good look at Joey. You can see him almost crouched over a little bit. Yeah. He's going to try and hit this thing on the way down in his swing right there. Didn't quite make it back.
Yeah.
Probably would have got back on lane six. Lane six seems to be hooking a little more.
Which is the other tough part, because both lanes can be totally different.
Yeah, exactly. When you're dealing with a thin pattern, the ratio of oil to dry boards is very small. It's like a flat pattern. Where like in a leaf pattern, you might have a ton of oil in the middle and very little on the outside. This is much flatter. Gotta hurry. Almost.
Ugh.
That's a killer.
That's a killer for Joe. Leaves himself an open in the seventh. No place to hide in a...
Yeah, if I know Nicky, this is going to be a real good shot right here. This is putting your foot on someone's throat right here time. Gonna set. Great shot right there.
Four in a row.
You see that one coming.
Very focused.
Yeah, he's not gonna give you a chance to breathe if he's got a chance. Too much experience right there.
And not a lot of places for Joe to hide at this point.
No. Well, he missed on the aggressive side. The ball went light because he got aggressive with it, so he didn't. You know, wimp it through the nose and hope it was going to be a good shot. He tried to make it a good shot. Oh, great shot right there for Nick. And a solid 10. Don't cross lane. There's no plastic product. Good throw.
Yeah,
well done.
He picks it up. All right, Joe needs to make a move here.
Yeah, it's crunch time. Most Joey can go out for his 223, and Nicky's working out at a 230 pace.
All right. Goes back and hangs 10 in the eighth. One ball at a time, I guess. There's a lot of pins to make up, about 40 pins between him and Nick right now.
I'm pretty sure that's the rule, though, Art. You can only throw one ball at a time.
But
thanks for putting that out there for our small fry.
I don't know. I've seen somebody throw two balls at a time.
Yeah. I've done it enough times. Good shot for Joe right there.
A little less oh, yeah. All right. A double when he needed it.
I can't see Nicky making too many mistakes, so. We're into the ninth frame. Working on 230.
Wow.
Just grabbed it. Just grabbed it a little bit at the bottom of the swing, ball running just a little high, leaving a 4-9. Go cross lane. Wow, tough break right there for Nicky.
Only gets the one.
All right, strike Sperry, still can shut out Joey. You can say, well, I can ask for his a chance. Deep breath. Going through his thought process. Boy, things can turn around fast here, Artie, just like you said, bud.
Opens up the door for Joe. See what Nick does here in the tenth, though.
Oh, that's left again. Oh, you got to be kidding me.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Not well, what he wanted to see.
That's the announcer's jinx right there.
Yeah.
To put on Mickey. Now he's got to make this. Going cross alley.
Not impossible, but definitely tough.
Exactly. Shooting at the 6-7. No. Good try.
Nice try, but no good.
Okay.
So he's an end.
Joey needs a double.
With a 214. Joe's sitting on a double right now.
He's the first two. He likes this lane because he can get it right. It's going to get back, so let's see what happens. Good ball speed. Got to hurry.
Eddie
got it.
First.
Wow.
Sometimes you can't give a guy an opening like that.
No. And between the two of these bowlers, you don't give either of them an opening.
Exactly right.
Because when it comes to crunch, they both can do what they got to do.
Exactly. Yep, the roles reverse. Mickey be striking right now, too. This is for the win. Gotta hurry.
That's it. It's
man,
over.
Man, oh man.
Joe Mazuryk, our champion in our single scratch. We will be back with the checks, the awards, and much more on Huck Finn's Capital Region Bowling on My Forum.
Welcome back. Highway Recreational here in Wynantskill. Huck Finn's Capital Region Bowling, our champion, Joe Mazuryk, with a 219-214 over Nick Miseno. And man, Kenny and I were talking. It was an up-and-down championship match. I mean, it could have gone either way. What changed for you those last few lanes, frames rather, that had you striking?
I was losing the left lane a little bit. I knew if I could get in the ninth, at least make Nick show up to at least give me an opportunity. I know as long as I can get a bowling ball in my hand with an opportunity to win, I know I have a shot. So, unfortunately, Nick got two bad breaks. He split, but I haven't been bowling much, but man, it feels good to get up there and need to throw a strike and get it. I forgot what it felt like, so I might be bowling a little more.
Well, and we said that either one of you know what to do really at crunch time. Kenny, Nicky bowled really good today, and unfortunately at the end it just didn't work out for him.
Nick, we worked together for a long time, and you're a very good friend, like family. Sometimes it just plain sucks, you know. Yeah. Nice job, though. I know you'll be back.
Absolutely, absolutely. Ninth frame, I thought he threw a fairly decent shot, but I got it in just a touch. At the 10th frame, it was just a horrible shot. The lanes weren't very forgiving and paid a penalty for throwing a bad shot. All the credit to Joe, though. He got up at the 10th frame and threw the quality pitches that he needed to.
Well, you're a class act and you're a good friend.
And our executive director, Carol Judge, has a little something for Nick.
I do. I have a nice check for $300. And, you know, when you're on the show, it's always fun to watch. I know it's going to be competitive, so congratulations. You're welcome.
And our proprietor here, our host, Artie Hoffmann, it's been great to be back here for our tournament. He has something here for Joe.
Thank you.
$600 check. Good job.
Thank you very much.
Great bowling.
Thank you.
Who gets trophy?
Both of us.
Okay.
Both of them get the trophy. All right. Good job. They're sharing it. It was a great day. I mean, all three matches really came down to the end. Great bowling. And, you know, just... you never know what it's going to turn. We've said it's a one-game match, and unfortunately, you don't get a lot of time to make
I tell you, a lot of times the conditions make the matches. This was a tricky shot. Like I said, they had to think, they had to execute, and that's what it came down to.
Yeah. Well, our season is almost over. As a matter of fact, you can join us this afternoon at 6 o'clock at Alpha Lanes in Troy as we will tape our annual Jack Scatia Senior Memorial Tournament, which will be the wrap of our 13th season of Huck Finn's Capital Region Bowling, and what a ride it has been this season, hasn't it?
Awesome parts.
So remember to join us, and until then, what do we say, Kenny?
Bowling is back!
shoes and grab your balls, and let's head to those heavenly halls. Sit on down and grab a beer, because bowling time is pretty near. Tortured men forget their pain when they head to the bowling lane. Let's go bowling. Let's go bowling. Got a coupon. Let's go bowling for a free game. Let's go bowling. Let's go bowling. Let's go bowling. Let's do it now, because WrestleMania's fine by me. Monster trucks are a sight to see. A culture like that's nice and all, but there ain't nothing better than a bowling ball. You know the sport that God would choose is the one with the three-tone leather sole shoes. Let's go bowling. Let's go bowling. Got a coupon. Let's go bowling. From a juice can. Let's go bowling. Let's go bowling. Let's go bowling. Let's do it now. Yes, bowling. The sport of kings, the sport of queens, the sport of dukes, earls, beaux, johns, anything that looks good when it's embroidered on a polyester shirt. And you know, bowling takes on this almost religious significance because it's so much like a religion. I mean, the ball is round like the earth, and it's got the Holy Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the thumb hole. And as you roll the ball down the alley of life, striking out the pagan religions of the past, sparing them the anguish of their lives in the gutter, framing their existence in an eternal metaphysicalness, something like the 7-10 split.